Hi everyone, this is Gurveen here, and today we'll be having a look at artifact security in Mocky. So in today's session, we'll be covering how Mocky provides us the support for authentication and how we can implement authorization, and we'll be talking all about this with respect to REST APIs. So let's start with authentication in security. So I have come here in the Mocky documentation under Mocky framework, and we have a security topic here. So we can easily reach out here to read about this. So when we talk about authentication, so it basically deals with verifying the user's identity. So how Mocky enables that is that it has the login user method in the user facade which it provides. So it takes in the username and password which we provide, and it will use the most widely used username password authentication token which is generated, and it will internally authenticate using the user account entity which is provided in the mocky.security package. So this user account entity, which actually holds the records for all the registered users, and it will have information like the user ID, username, password hash, if the account is disabled, and many such information which Mocky will use to authenticate the user. So if we talk about internals, this uses the Apache Shiro for the actual authentication. So we can always have a look at the code, and it uses the user password token, which we just talked about, using the username and password. And if we have a look at subject, then this actually represents various security operations which we will perform against the application user. So here for authentication, it will use the login method. So using this, Mocky can authenticate the incoming user. And there are some default settings which we have with respect to authentication. So these are available in the Mocky default configuration file under the user facade element. So basically it has these three elements which we can use to configure various settings. Like say for login, we can configure the number of maximum failed attempts for the login and before disabling the user account, and for how long you want to disable. Similarly, you can also say if you want to store the history of the failed attempts or the incorrect passwords, you can also do so. Then Mocky also provides us a login API key, for which we can also set some properties, like we can tell which hash algorithm to use and for how long that key will be valid before it expires. Now there may be possibility that you want to add some password constraints as per your need in the application. So we can do so using the password element. So again, we have various settings, like we have the hash algorithm, then the minimum number of characters, the digits and other characters which we want to use. Now all these are available in the Mocky default configuration XML file, which ships along with the framework under the user facade element. Now, based on our need, we can always override these settings in our components, in our runtime components, Mocky configuration file. So as per our need, we can change the settings and we can go ahead with the settings which we want to apply for our authentication and password constraints. So once the user's identity is verified, now the next thing which we need to take care is its access to the various resources which we have developed. So with Mocky, we have two ways. We can do it using permissions, and then we can do it using artifact authorization. So with permissions, we can do so using the user facade's has permission method, which we can check against a permission string. So it goes by the logic that the user will have a permission. If the user is a member of the group that has the permission, So the entities which gets involved here are the user group member, user group, and the user group permission. Now this is one way of doing it, but with this approach, we'll have to check against each artifact using this permission for the access, that whether the user has the access to that particular artifact. When we say artifact, it can be anything in Mocky. As we know, it can be a service, it can be a transition, a screen, or a REST API. So, and also we need to add the checks in the code. So there is another flexible and more better way we can do it is using the artifact authorization. So the advantage here with artifact authorization is that you don't have to change your code. You don't have to add any explicit check for each and every artifact. You can add the needed configuration external to your code, and we can do it at the application level, and this authorization is, we can make it inheritable. So we'll have a look at how we can implement artifact authorization for a REST API type component which we have developed. So the more details are added below, but this example is of screen, so we'll have a look at this in the upcoming sessions. But in this session, let us say we want to add authorization to our REST APIs to make them secure. So how we will do this, we will have a look. So I will jump to the IDE for this. So what I've done is I have just created a demo component for this purpose, and I have created the REST XML file. So I have added just some simple resources, say to get orders. Now, if we recall our session of REST APIs, so we would have given the require authentication here to anonymous view or all, but this would have made our APIs accessible, but this is not the desired scenario for us right now. So we want to add the authorization capabilities to the resources which we have developed. So my root demo path is demo. And let us see that if I have come till here, I have developed my resources, whether I will be able to access it or not. So let me go to Postman once. So as we know that to access the REST API, I have given the root path demo, and there is the orders resource which I want to access. And I'm using the test user which Mocky provides, John Doe. So, and I have just got an API key. I can get an API key, and using this, since the user is a valid user, it is authenticated. And let me just change this. And if I want to, if I try to get this, I'm not able to get do a view on the orders, as the user is not yet authorized to do so. So how we can do that? So so we will add some configuration and authorization records. So how we do that is, so I've created a demo security data file. Now the step one will be to create a group of artifacts, and then I will add an artifact group member record for this artifact. So here my artifact is the REST API path. So you can create an artifact group record. You can give an ID to it, and then the description of what this artifact is, artifact group is about. Then I will add a group member to it. So in this example, I'm trying to give the access to the root demo, REST API path, so which is demo. And the artifact type enum will be at rest path. And the interesting thing is here, we have given the inherit authorization as Y. This means that we have implemented the inheritable authorization. Now this means that not only this specified artifact, the demo path, is authorized, but everything else which it is using, say the different resources, the path underneath it, the entities and the services, everything will get authorized if we have set this inherit authorization to true. So once I have this artifact group and artifact group member in place, now I will create an authorization for this group with an authorization record. So we have this artifact authorization under security. So we have given an ID. Now, since the test user which I'm using is of user group admin, so I've given the user group. We can always, as per our requirement, create a group of users and we can give the authorization accordingly. Then I've added the artifact group ID, which is we just created demo API. And currently I am giving the authorization for all the actions. So the authorization action enum is authorization all. So I just want to show that the possible values for this. So I have come under security entities. So under authorization, artifact authorization entity, we can see some seed data. So currently we have given the authorization to all, but say as per our need, we can, if we want to create only the view type authorization, we can use as per the values which are provided here, view, create, update, or delete. Then the next important thing is the authorization type. So here authorization type I've given is as allow. So let us just once check the values. So we have three values, allow, deny, and always allow. Now there are special behaviors for deny and always allow. So if I want to say if I have a sensitive service or REST API path for which I do not want to give the access to the user, I can always set up the artifact authorization record and set it to deny. Now this deny will override the allow type. And if we want to always allow the user for the authorization for the artifact, then we have to set it as always. This will override the deny setting as well. So we need to keep in mind for what type of authorization we want to implement and add the value. So here I've added this settings. So after we have added the security data here, I will just go to console and I will load this data. So after this data gets loaded, the expected behavior is that the user John Doe should have been given authorization for the demo path and he should be able to access the orders resource. So after this, let me quickly run the application. So let us go to Postman to see what effect it has now. So if I try to access the orders, now we can see that we are able to get the records. Say if I want to access a particular order, let me refresh. So we are able to do so. So you can see that this orders is actually getting information from a lot of entities and we have not set any explicit authorization for any of it. So just by giving the authorization to the demo path, we are able to access all the resources underneath it. Now say we have any, just for an example for the deny authorization, say I have an API resource for which I do not want the particular user group to have access to. So just for an example, I have the path here. If I go to REST XML file, so under order paths, I have a payments resource and I do not want access for this particular user group. So I can do so. So I've created another artifact group, an artifact member for this particular path. And the main thing, the setting which I have done is I have given the authorization type as deny. So now as what we saw that this deny should override the allow. So if I go here to Postman and if I say want to access the payments for this particular order. So you can see the user is not authorized to have a view on this, even though we had the setting of allow on the root demo path. But we can always have these settings as per the need and do not give access to the sensitive services and the resources in our application. So for the reference, for the code reference, we can always have a look at the example component. So the same example, a similar example is there in the example security data. So we have the REST path for the root path of example. And so here there were a lot of examples. So I wanted to cover only the REST API path. And we'll be covering this, how we can add the authorization for screens in the upcoming sessions. So is there anything which you would like to discuss here? There are any questions for this?
Well, I see there are no questions as of now. So anyways, Mocky mailing list is always there. We can put up questions there and have a conversation there if required afterwards. And as usual, this session video will be uploaded to YouTube and will be accessible to everyone.
Thank you, everyone, for joining.